All right, so here's a quick video of a jukebox that I've got in the shop here. This is a 1964 AMI Roe, or Roe AMI, Tropicana. So Tropicana, Tropicana's a very... That's a great name for a jukebox that's got this sort of, I don't know, I'm going to call it like a Vegas loungy... It's very Lounge Lizard. Very Rat Pack era. You know, the colors are great. It's got this tacky red. Has this awesome, I don't know what you call it. It's an effect that actually will change as the music plays. The colors change and it'll sort of pulse with the music. Super cool. Great album art. In fact, this is kind of cool too. This was in a place called the Open Face Sandwich Club, which I don't really know very much about, but this album was recorded there, I guess, Eddie Mac. So don't know a whole lot about that, but it seems like it was a pretty swinging place, I can just imagine. So, and yeah, Nacho Cat's a big fan of this one too. He likes the Vegas lounge vibes. That's right. Oh, yes. Jeez, okay, whoa, don't get too excited. what can I tell you about this? This, in the 60s, a lot of these machines, by this time, you couldn't see the record playing anymore. Like, back in the 50s, you know, the record was on full display. By 1964, that was all hidden away, and then they'd gone sort of full-on tackiness, you know, and they'd go for the cool, you know, just, you know, vibrant colors and, you know, funky stuff like this. This still has... Hey, relax. This still has a bit of that elegant sort of upright stature that the earlier machines had. Hey, buddy, cool it. One of the problems... Well, problems. It's not a problem, but one of the... something that happened to jukeboxes, I guess, as the 60s kind of came in... they started getting kind of fat and squatty, and they would look like, you know, big console, you know, they looked more like furniture than they did jukeboxes. In the 50s, they all looked like, you know, they almost built them like cars, you know, they had big glass windshields and lots of chrome. Well, this is a nice kind of crossover. You still get a lot of the chrome, you get your big clunky buttons, you know, you get the tacky artwork, you know, all the cheese. You know, if this was a few years older, you'd probably have a visible mech. But being that it was 1964, they went with this sort of loungy look, and you know what? In the right place, this is a pretty cool-looking jukebox. And it's a Roe, so very, very well built. These are super... The quality on these is fantastic. You know, just big, solid cabinet. And this one's in fantastic shape. Yeah, that's right, buddy. Fantastic shape. A real survivor. It's got all of its original bits. The chrome is clean. What else can I tell you about it? This jukebox has what is called Stereo in the Round, and Stereo in the Round was something that AMI had been doing in the past, like with their Continental Series jukes, and I guess it's just a way that they, I'm going to use the term processed, that they, you know, it was an effect that they, that their jukeboxes did where... I'm going to probably describe it horribly, but one of the channels was inverted and the amp did something special with that. And you've got 1, 2, 3, 4 speakers on this thing. And it does some weird thing where it fills a room at low volumes. It's got a very warm, full sound. And it was a unique thing to, you know, rose from this era. So, okay. Anyway, before this gets too long, let me play some music here. Let's see here. And we'll get a look at what's going on underneath the lid here. That's what the magic is all about. Very cool. As you can see, very clean under here. Everything's been serviced. Like I said, amplifier rebuilt, that mechanism has been serviced. There we go. Oh, well, we can turn it up a little bit. My goodness. Let's get a little Stereo in the Round here. Now that is cool. And there you go.